Using the right animations can be one of the ways to help bring your designs to life. With Figma's powerful yet simple tools, adding motion to your designs has never been easier, especially with the help of Smart Animate. In this video, we'll cover some of the most commonly used animations that are easy to learn, which you can start incorporating to your next design project. Let's jump straight into it. The first interaction that I'll be covering is a simple on-click interaction, and this is probably the one that you're going to use the most when you're building prototypes for your web apps, for your mobile apps. The animation that I'm trying to achieve here is I have a screen for a social media app, and in the profile screen we have three tabs: posts, videos, and reposts. When I click on this other tab, I want the screen to transition to this other set of content, and also the highlighted tab is gonna switch place. So if I click on repost, it's gonna switch to repost, and if I click back on the post, the content beneath should switch back to the post. I'm gonna preview this animation and later I'll break it down how you can set this up easily. So first we're on the post tab, and if I click on the videos tab, you can see that the red highlight here smoothly slides into the right place, whereas the content beneath, it slides out of the way. So if I click on repost, it slides that way. Now if I click on videos, the content goes the other direction. Same thing if I go back here, so slides to the left, and then this one slides to the right. In order to achieve that, it's very simple. All you have to do is set up a set of components for the tabs. I'll break down how you can create this component very easy. So I'll copy that and detach that, so you can really see how the component is made. So basically it's just a frame that contains three boxes plus this red bar, which is absolute position. So this is not a stroke of the first box, but this is a separate frame. I just set all three frames with to fill, so they each fill in exactly 1/3 of the entire container's width. And then the bar, just set it the same width as one of the container. Remember to put it in absolute position to achieve that gliding effect. So for videos tab, just put in bar right in the middle of the container, and then the third tab can just align that to the right side. Now once you got that set up, you don't want to do the interaction on this component itself, but you want to do the interaction on the screens that you want the animation to take place on. So if I click on Shift E, or you can just go to the prototype tab here, which is basically the same thing. You see that I have all of these interactions set up. Let's go to the first one here. This is very simple. So you just add the connection here from videos tab to the correct screen. And then the third tab, just add that to the correct screen as well. And you want to do that for these other two screens. As for the sliding in and out effect for the content here, if I take this here, uncheck this box as well, you can see that actually the content is set up so that all three of these different tabs is in the same container. So if I expand this a little bit, I have three auto layouts here. So 1, 2, 3, and then each one represents the respective tabs. When I switch to the other section, so for example, the videos here, I just change the alignment of this container. So for the first tab, I just have this box aligned to the left. For the middle section, I just aligned this to the center of the container, and then to the right side for the third tab. And that's how you achieve that sliding animation. And once you got the connection set up, just make sure that you have the animation set to Smart Animate. This one you can just leave on default. I just increased the duration a little bit from 300 milliseconds to 400 to make it a little bit slower. This is the setup that I usually use. Just use Smart Animate and Figma will take care of the rest. The second one is hover interaction, and again this is fairly simple to set up. So it's mainly used for buttons where you indicate when the user cursor is within the button. It kind of changes the appearance, typically it gets a little bit darker. So I'll do that with this blue button right here. I'll just copy outside and turn this into a component, Control Alt K, add a new variant, name this hover, change the property name to state. When it's hovered, I want the color to get a little bit darker. So let's just change the lightness value by 10, and that's basically it. Now we want to connect the main variant, the plus icon, change the trigger to while hovering. And you can leave the animation at Smart Animate, ease out 300 milliseconds. This is the default settings. For most of the case, it works fine. It looks good. So you can just leave it at that. You can copy the default version of the instance, paste this inside here. And now we can just remove the old one. Now, if we play the prototype, you can see that it works fine. When I enter here, it changes to the hover state, just like we specified. There's also another way that you can play around with the hover interaction. And I'm going to do that with one of the cards here. So this has an image within it. And when I hover on the card, I want the image within to zoom in a little bit. So I'm going to drag this out here, change this into a component, Control Alt K, add a new variant. Let's reposition that for a bit. Now rename this second one hover, change the property name to state. Let's resize this a little bit. So once it's being hovered, I want the image within to zoom in a little bit. So we can just scale this, maybe 1.1. And you can just simply connect the first variant. Again, change the trigger to while hovering. Smart animate, 200 milliseconds. And now you copy the default version of the component, paste it here, position it correctly. And now when we play the prototype, you can see, once I enter the card, the image within gets zoomed in a little bit. So that's a nice little effect that you can add on to your website or your web app if you have some visuals that you want it to have some sort of hover interaction. The next one is an on-drag interaction, and this is where the user would click or tap on a certain element and they move it from the original position. I'm going to show you this timer, and this is basically mimicking what it does on a mobile device. If I click and hold onto the cursor and drag this across, you can see that it achieves this dragging effect that you would have if you were using a touch-based device. And to set that up, it's very easy. So I have three different states of the screen here. If I uncheck clip content here, you can see that each of these has way more than what it's being shown initially. So for the minutes, I have 1 through 5. And then the seconds here, starting from 29 to 34. The minutes is an auto layout frame, so it stacks perfectly. Same thing, this one is also an auto layout. But the frame that contains both the minutes and the seconds auto layouts is not an auto layout. This is just a regular frame. And just duplicate that. And then in the second variant, all I'm doing is simply just changing the position of the first one here. This minutes frame, you see the parent container is exactly at the top. And then on here, I just changed this from this to here. So you align that perfectly. You want to leave this one the same. And then in the third one, let's open this up. You can see that the first one is already set. We don't want to play around with that. Now you want to change the position of the seconds. Now in this one, again, I just drag this all the way up so that the bottom hits exactly the bottom of the parent container. Clip content again. Now for the interaction itself, you want to make sure that you connect the points from the actual frame that is being dragged on. So in this case, it's this frame, which contains the minutes that is being dragged, not the parent container here. And then place it onto the parent's frame. So this is the key thing that you have to note when you're using drag interaction. If you connect this frame to this frame, or the parent to the parent, then it's not gonna work. Let's try that just so you know. So if I connect this parent frame instead and change the trigger to on drag, now you can see as I'm dragging here, it's not really drag. It's just like a simple smart animate. So all I'm doing is just click and then it instantly changes state to the second one. So you don't want that. You don't have that dragging effect. Whereas if you connect it from the actual frame that you want to move to the parent's frame, now let's play this again. You can see that I can control it with my mouse, how slow I want. I can just reverse the process. As long as I don't hit the second variant, it's gonna keep on playing the interaction. So that's the interaction that you want to have in your design when you're using drag interaction. The next one I'll be covering is the after delay transition. So this trigger is used to automatically transition from one state to another or trigger a pop-up automatically without the user having to interact or click or hover on anything. For this example, let's say I want this screen. So when I click on add, I want this loading state to show as an overlay in the middle of the screen. for a brief couple of seconds, and then it automatically changes to this completed or sent state. So from this to this, we don't want any user interaction. We just want a specific time before this state changes to this one. So what I'm gonna do is you can go simply to the prototype mode. I've already connected that here. So you click on the trigger that you want to show the initial overlay. So this one is not an after delay. This is a click interaction. So when I click on the add button, then this overlay would show up. This action, if you're using overlay, you want to make sure that this is changed to open overlay, not navigate to. So open overlay, and then you can adjust the position, top left, top center, top right. I'll just use center. I'm going to add the background, and let's change this to 30% black, and let's play this one first. So when I click on add, now it automatically shows the overlay for the loading. So this one is working fine, but now we don't want this to keep loading forever. We just want this to maybe like for 1 or 1.5 second, and then it instantly changes to this state over here. In order to do that, it's very simple. You just go to this overlay and connect the two. Now this trigger you want to change to after delay. Let's add in maybe 1400 milliseconds, so it's a bit slower, and you can see the loading state for a little bit longer. And the action, again, you don't want this to navigate to. You want to change this to swap overlay. Animation, it can be smart animate, but for this one, I typically just use instant. So we don't need any type of smart transition there. And now if we play, I click on add, it's going to load a little bit, and it automatically changes to this request send state. Now, if we want the overlay to go away automatically, again, we can use the same transitions. Let's add that one more time, add interaction, the trigger. Let's change this to after delay. This is where you specify how long do you want this panel to show before it automatically goes away by itself. So let's do 1000 milliseconds. So 1 second, and the action, close overlay. Let's do that one final time. Click on add, it's gonna load a little bit, changes to the request send, and it automatically goes away. That's basically how after delay transition works. So the last one I'll talk about today is the mouse enter and leave interaction. And I'll show you how you can use this to animate sections on a landing page. Let's play this prototype here. So as I'm scrolling down a little bit, you can see how once this section comes into the viewport, the cards down here animate slowly, they fade in and slide in nicely from the bottom. And also the text and the button here have the same animation as well. So let's reload that to see the animation once again. Scroll down, and they come in using this nice but subtle animations. So how you can set that up is very easy. First, I have this website section built using auto layout. So the main frame is called screen, and then I have the top nav, the hero block, the what we offer block, and this has been turned into a component. And also the last one is the about section. Now, to use this interaction, especially when animating landing pages like this, you want to change the whole block or the whole section into a component, which is what I've done here. And for this to work smoothly, I would usually remove all auto layouts from the frame. So keep the design using auto layout, but for prototyping purposes, you want to make a copy of that and remove all the auto layouts within that block. You can see that it's all just regular frames, and this is not an auto layout as well. This card, it can stay as an auto layout, but the container that contains the elements that we want to animate, I usually just remove the auto layout and change that into a regular frame. And now you just create a new variant of that. The second one is the default state, and then the first one you can just play around with the positioning. You can see how the text here, I've moved this 40 pixels down, and same thing with the cards, I just move it down 90 pixels down. Play around with the opacity, you can play around with the scale, the rotation. But for this example, I just modify the opacity and the y-axis a little bit. And then you can just connect the two by using mouse enter trigger. And you can do the animation using smart animate. And the duration, you want this a little bit longer. So typically it has 300 milliseconds as the default value. I just changed this to 800 or 1000 milliseconds. That's basically it. You just plug that section back into the website and you play. It's not actually your mouse entering that section, it's actually your section entering the mouse since you're scrolling down, but it basically achieves what we're trying to see with the animation here. Let's create that real quick with this other section here. And I'm just gonna take this whole block out, turn this into a component. So we wanna strip down all the auto layouts. So this text, let's remove auto layout. This box, let's remove auto layout. We create a new variant. So this is the destination, which is the correct position with the elements and everything. And this is the before state. We can just play around with the text. Let's just move this down a little bit, change the appearance to maybe 10%. So this our team text, I want it to slide in from the left instead. So let's move this a little bit here. Let's also adjust the appearance to 60% or maybe even 20 to match headings. As for this box, I want this to slide in from the bottom. So let's move this down here. Let's change the appearance to 20 as well. The box, let's scale this up a little bit, 1.1. Now you can just add a mouse enter trigger, change this to mouse enter. The animation can be smart animate. Let's make the duration 1000, so it's a little bit longer. Copy the component instance, paste this onto the mainframe. And again, you wanna paste the before state. So when everything looks messed up, but it's gonna change to the right state once the mouse enters. So let's play this once again. As I scroll down more, you can see now everything comes in nicely. It has all the effects that we've set up on the components. Let's reload that once again. In order to reset the animation, you'll have to add another connection, which is mouse leave. So if we want this interaction to keep happening as I'm leaving the section, goes out of view, and then once it's scrolled in again, it goes back in with the same animation. You just need to add a mouse leave. So I'll connect this to this before state and change the trigger to mouse leave. You can leave the animation same. If we play that again, once my mouse enters, it triggers the first interaction. And as I scroll down, so my mouse is already leaving that section up there. And you can see that the opacity of the text has already decreased as it goes back to the initial variant again. And as I scroll back up, now we can see the interaction happening again. So that's it for today's video. I hope this gives you a better understanding on how you can incorporate some of these interactions. If you found the video helpful, give it a like, consider subscribing, leave a comment, and I'll see you on the next one.